I was after the iconic American military go-anywhere vehicle that is the Humvee.
Steve!
I didn't just find one, though. I found hundreds. So I needed some help from Ed.
Mike, I think I found it.
It wasn't quite battle-ready, but we worked through the night to bring it back to life.
Ready? Aha! Yeah, nice one.
Good job.
And once the differential was reattached, we were finally on the road, or off the road.
Wow!
We bought ourselves a Humvee.
Nice.
And then set about creating the ultimate go-anywhere camping vehicle.
We're going to have pretty much everything except for a kitchen sink. Oh, no, actually, that is just going to go down there somewhere.
It certainly looks the part now, but how much did taking home comforts into the wilderness actually cost us? Well, the vehicle itself was $12,500. That included all the scavenged parts from the field. The camper modifications cost us $5,800, and the paint job was $1,400. Along with the miscellaneous costs of $473, this gives us a military-grade total of $20,173 and 62 man-hours. This wagon means business, and it's time to go to work.
Look at that! Now that is one mean looking camper. I absolutely love it. And I love it in that colour. It looks so rugged.
Which is running beautifully. I went over all of our field repairs, and the starter circuit and the transaxle both work beautifully. They're still tip-top, as is the rest of the vehicle, so she's ready to go.
Perfect. I'll drive.
OK, well, it's pretty better, because I don't really fit in this thing.
Oh, look at it inside. It's brilliant.
I'm looking forward to this. Right, run. Oh, look at that. The glow light went off straight away. See, that's all fixed. Does it start from cold?
Well, actually, she starts reliably, whether hot or cold, which is rather good.
Fantastic.
Woo! All right!
Oh, and it feels lovely. Immediately you get behind the wheel, you have the air of, well, superiority sitting right up high. Right, our first big boulder to face, ready? Oh! But we're okay because we've got about 16 inches of ground clearance, which is good for a vehicle of this size. Did you know the Humvee has a 72-inch track, which means it's pretty wide, and because of that width of the track, it means it can go over like this on a slope angle of about 40%, which is a lot, let me tell you.
Well, it's actually 22 degrees, in fact. But what's really interesting is this thing, because of its center of gravity, is so low that it won't actually start to roll over until it gets to 55 degrees.
Oh, well, we're not doing that. We are not doing that.
I definitely don't want to be in the vehicle when that happens.
Okay, I said I wanted to go somewhere where nobody's been before.
Yep.
And I'm sort of pretty determined to get to the top of this hill.
Uh-huh.
But now looking at it, I'm thinking this looks more scary than I first thought, right? Because that looks steep. In fact, I know that this has got a slope angle. This can go up to 60%.
Yep.
And that looks like it's probably 60%.
Well, that's about 31 degrees. Now, I still got to tell from here, but it's got to be very, very close to that. So, good luck with that, mate.
I'm going to use a bit of CTM, which is controlled throttle modulation.
Okay.
As you can see, I've got my foot on the throttle,
yeah,
and I'm using just the brake to feather it to make sure I've got grip all the way round, and I'm getting this up here, up the hill. But you can see I'm actually sliding off my seat. Am I going the right way, do you reckon it?
I think you are. Give it a go.
Or should we go here?
No, give it a go. Give it a go. This is good. This is good.
You say it's good. This bit's not going to be good. This bit's really steep. Oh, it slips.
Oh, that's amazing. Just keep it nice and calm. Nice and calm. There we go.
Just don't look over the edge. Whatever you do, don't look over the edge. Oh, yes, baby! Yes!
That is absolutely amazing. There is no way any camper has ever been here before.
Never. I mean, people are thrown up
here. Oh, that is
but
awesome.
Not in a camper.
Actually, it's quite nice and flat here.
Oh, wait, that was...
I think we found our little campsite location.
That was absolutely brilliant. Oh, look at that! That is absolutely epic. I reckon we're the first people to ever consider even camping up here.
Absolutely, and what a wonderful spot. It's almost level.
It's perfect, isn't it? Right, come on, let's camp up.
Obviously, if we're going to have our little dining room table and chairs laid out there, we're going to need a kitchen. So check this out. So again, if you pull it out, pop it down. There we are.
You it's are fantastic. Kidding me. We've got a kitchen with a burner and a saucepan.
Got a little skillet as well, yes. And of course, we're going to need to have some coffee tomorrow morning. So obviously, to go with that, we've got a little espresso maker as well.
What about the food? Where are we going to keep the food then?
Well, the food is actually...
No, we've got a refrigerator.
In the fridge. Well, I say food in the fridge. Actually got our little bottle of champagne because we're going to celebrate making it all the way here.
You've absolutely nailed it.
There's one last thing. Obviously, once we've actually had our nice steak and whatever we're going to eat with it, raccoon probably, I guess, up in here.
No.
So you can do the washing up.
Does it plum
do? Of course it does.
No. Oh, well, that is brilliant. This is the ultimate go anywhere home from home, isn't it?
It really
I can't
is.
Wait to spend a night up here on top of this ridge. You better get that champagne crack, son, and we'll discuss the price.
Okay. So we've done it. We have proven that you can definitely make an extreme off-roading camper van out of a Humvee. So I guess from these heady heights, what kind of money are we going to sell it for?
Well, I have seen them in standard spec go anywhere between $10,000 and $15,000, but this is in no way standard spec, is it? For that reason alone, I'm really going to push it. I'm going to go for $25,000, which is around £16,500. All we got to do is take a picture of us sitting up here with that Humvee at the top of a mountain, and whoever comes to see it and sees that picture, they're going to buy it, trust me.
Definitely going to drink to that.
Why are we drinking champagne out of espresso mugs?
Well, we are roughing it.
Cheers. Click here to subscribe.